Namaste, and once again welcome back to another session of online mathematics class. Today we are going to discuss a new chapter called Lines and Angles. It is the sixth chapter of NCERT class 9 mathematics text. First of all, we can discuss some basic concept in lines and angles. Let us start. We all know line segment and ray. Okay, what's the difference between them? Line segment, ray. Okay, we all familiar with these terms. So line we can extend indefinitely on either sides. Okay, it's a collection of points which lie on a same line. We can extend indefinitely on both sides. Line segment is a part of line which has two endpoints. Line segment is a part of line which has two endpoints. And ray is also a part of a line which has one endpoint. Okay, one initial point, but it has no terminal point. It is called ray. Now we shall discuss the terms collinear points and non-collinear points. Collinear points and non-collinear points. By collinear points, we mean three or more points lie on the same line are called as collinear points. Three or more points lie on the same line are called collinear points. Otherwise, they are called non-collinear points. Next one is angle. We know angle is formed when two rays originated from same initial point. Here I am going to draw two rays that are originated from same point. Okay, this common point is called a vertex, and the rays forming the angles are known as arms of the angle. So these are called arms of the angle, and this point is called originated point is called what? Vertex of the angle. Now we shall discuss types of angles. There are different types of angles. First one is acute angle. Acute angle. If the angle measure is less than 90 degree, then the angle is called what? Acute angle. That is, here the angle measure, if you take it as x, then this measure lies between 0 degree and 90 degree. 0 degree less than x, less than 90 degree. Okay, so this type of angles are called acute angles. So if the measure of angles lies between 0 degree and 90 degree, then the angle is called what? Acute angle. Then second one is right angle. We all know what is a right angle. If the angle measure is equal to 90 degree, then it is called what? Right angle. Here I mark the angle as Y, and here Y is equal to what? 90 degree. Okay, so if the angle measure is equal to 90 degree, then it is called the right angle. Then the third one is obtuse angle. Obtuse angle. If the angle measure is greater than 90 degree and less than 180 degree, then it is called obtuse angle. Okay, if the measure of angle is more than 90 degree and less than 180 degree, so we can write 90 degree less than, here it is said, so less than is said, less than 180 degree. The angle which lies between 90 degree and 180 degree is called what? Obtuse angle. Okay. And another one is straight angle. Let it be T. If the angle measure is equal to 180 degree. So here T is equal to 180 degree. Then it is called what? Straight angle. The angle measure is equal to 180 degrees. Then it is called a straight angle. And the next one is reflex angle. Reflex angle. So if the angle measure is more than 180 degree and less than 360 degree, then it is called a what? Reflex angle. So if we take the angle as S, here we can write 180 degree less than S, less than 360 degree. So if the angle measure is more than 180 degrees and less than 360 degrees, then we can say the angle is reflex angle. So these are the five different types of angles. I repeat, first one is acute angle. Acute angle means the angle measure is more than 0 degree and less than 90 degree, then it is called what? Acute angle. Right angle, if the angle measure is equal to 90 degree, then it is called right angle. Obtuse angle, if the angle measure is more than 90 and less than 180, then it is called obtuse angle. Straight angle, if the angle measure is equal to 180 degrees, then it is called a straight angle. Reflex angle, if the angle measure is more than 180 and less than 360, then it is called a reflex angle. Okay. Next, we can discuss pairs of angles. Okay. First one is complementary angles. Complementary angles. So, complementary angles means two angles are said to be complementary if the sum of those angles will be equal to 90 degree. Okay. If the sum of two angles is equal to 90 degree, then they are called complementary angles. Okay. Similarly, there is one more term, supplementary angles. Supplementary angles. So two angles are said to be supplementary if the sum of two angles will be equal to 180 degrees. So if the sum of two angles is equal to 180 degrees, then we can say the angles are supplementary. Clear? Then the next one is adjacent angles. Adjacent angles. Two angles are said to be adjacent angles if they have a common vertex and a common arm, and the non-common arms are on the either side of the common arm. Okay. Two angles are said to be adjacent if they have a common vertex and common arm, and the non-common arms are on either side of the common arm. Okay. So figure is like this. Here these two angles, namely we can mark AO, B, here C. Here angle AOC and angle BOC. Angle AOC and angle BOC are adjacent angles since they have a common vertex O and the common arm is OC. And the non-common arms, what are the non-common arms here? OB and OA are on either side of the common arm. Okay. Two angles are said to be adjacent if they have a common vertex and common arm, and the non-common arms are on either side of the common arm. Okay. Next one is linear pair of angles. Linear pair of angles. Two adjacent angles are said to be a linear pair if the non-common arms of the angle forms a line. Okay. If OA and OB forms a line, then we can say these two angles are adjacent angles are what? Linear pair of angles. So here we can draw the figure like this. C, here B, here O. This OA I am going to straighten. Here it is A. Okay. Now angle AOC and angle BOC are adjacent angles. At the same time, the non-common arms, namely OA and OB, forms a line. Clear? So two adjacent angles are said to be linear pair of angles if the non-common arms of the angles form a line. Clear? And the next one is vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. It's one of the important type of angles, vertically opposite angle. So vertically opposite angles are formed when two lines crosses each other or intersect each other. Okay. If you draw two lines like this, crosses, the angle formed, the pair of angle formed are called a vertically opposite angle. Okay. The angle just opposite to each other. If we name the point as O, here AB and CD are two lines. These two lines intersect at the point O and the two lines form two pairs of angles. AOC and BOD, these two are vertically opposite angles, and BOC and AOD are another pair of vertically opposite angles. Clear? So if two lines crosses, the angles formed just opposite to one another are called what? Vertically opposite angles. Clear? Next one is intersecting lines and non-intersecting lines. Intersecting lines and non-intersecting lines. So intersecting lines means when two lines crosses or meet at a point, the two lines are called intersecting lines. Okay. So here these two lines intersect or meet at a common point. Okay, common vertex. So these lines are called what? Intersecting lines. If the two lines doesn't intersect each other, then they are called non-intersecting lines. Or otherwise it is called parallel lines. Okay, never intersecting lines. Parallel lines. One important point you have to keep in mind is, if you take the perpendicular distance between these two lines at any point, the all the distance will be same. Okay, these all values will be equal. If it is h, all are equal to h. If it is 4 units, all are equal to 4 units. That's why the lines doesn't intersect. Okay, the lines keep the same distance between them. Okay, so these types of lines are called what? Non-intersecting lines or parallel lines. Okay, next we have two axioms. First one is, if a ray stands on a line, then the sum of two adjacent angles so formed is 180 degree. Very simple. Consider a line L, and if a ray stands on this line, here it is a ray that stands on the line L. Then the sum of two adjacent angles are formed. These are two adjacent angles. The sum of these two angles will be equal to how much? 180 degree. Sum is equal to 180 degree. And we know if the non-common arms of two adjacent angles forms a line, then the angles are called what? Linear pair of angles. And clearly we can say these two angles are what? Linear pair. Okay. And what we can conclude? Linear pair means sum of angles will be equal to 180 degree. That point also you have to keep in mind. Okay. Then the second one is, if the sum of two adjacent angles is 180 degrees, the converse of the first one, reverse of the first one, if the sum of two adjacent angles is 180 degree, then the non-common arms of the angle forms a line. Okay. If we measure these two angles and add the angles, if we get 180 degree, then what we can say? The non-common arms. That means this much distance and this much distance. Okay. If we mark it as O, here A and B, OA and OB. Okay. OA and OB are the non-common arms. That non-common arms forms a line. That means here AOB is a line. Since the sum of these two angles is how much? 180 degree. And these two axioms are known as linear pair axiom. Linear pair axiom. I repeat, first one is, if a ray stands on a line, then the sum of two adjacent angles so formed is 180 degree. And the second one is, if the sum of two adjacent angles is 180 degree, then the non-common arms of the angle forms a line. Understood? Next one is an important theorem. If two lines intersect each other, then the vertically opposite angles are equal. If two lines intersect each other, then the vertically opposite angles are equal. That we have to prove. So in order to prove this theorem, we can draw one pair of angles, vertically opposite angles. Name it as AB, then CD. Here we can mark O. So AOC and BOD. These are one pair of vertically opposite angles. And another pair is AOD. This one AOD and BOC. So what we have to prove is the vertically opposite angles are equal. That is AOC equal to BOD and AOD equal to BOC. Okay. So we can start with angle AOD. So from the figure, we can write angle AOD plus, take the adjacent angle, angle BOD. Okay. AOD, BOD. Angle BOD, which is equal to 180 degrees. Take it as equation number 1. Linear pair axiom. Okay. AOB is a line. So, sum of these two angles will be 180 degree. And next we can write angle BOD plus BOD. Next adjacent angle BOC. Angle BOC equal to 180 degree. Take it as equation number 2. Next, take the next pair BOC, AOC. Angle BOC plus angle AOC equal to 180 degrees. Take it as equation number 3. We can write the common reason here, linear pair axiom. By linear pair axiom. Okay. If the non-common arms of the angle forms a line, then the sum of the angles will be equal to how much? 180 degrees. First, we can compare first two equations. So, from 1 and 2, what we can write, RHS part is equal, so we can equate the LHS part, angle AOD plus angle BOD equal to angle BOD plus angle BOC. Okay, here we can cancel angle BOD and angle BOD, therefore we get angle AOD equal to angle BOC. AOD, BOC, these two angles. Okay, next we can consider equation 2 and 3. So from 2 and 3 we get LHS of 2 is BOD plus BOC, angle BOD plus angle BOC, which is equal to, and in the third equation, angle BOC plus angle AOC. Here also we can cancel angle BOC, therefore we get angle BOD is equal to angle AOC. It is the next pair. BOD, this one, AOC, this one. So we have proved that two lines intersect each other, then the vertically opposite angle formed are equal. Understood? Now we move on to exercise 6.1. Here the first question is, in figure, lines AB and CD intersect at O. If angle AOC plus angle BOE equal to 70 degree and angle BOD equal to 40 degree, here it is 40 degree, find angle BOE and reflex angle COE. Okay, so first of all we can write, given angle AOC plus angle BOE equal to 70 degree and angle BOD equal to 40 degree. Okay, these two things are given. AOC plus BOE, AOC, this angle AOC, then plus BOE, this one. Sum of these two angles is equal to how much? 70 degree. And if we add one more angle to this, we get 180 degree. This much measure. Okay, COE. So if we add COE to this one, we will get how much? 180 degree linear pair of angles. Okay, or straight angle. AOB is a straight line, so this much angle will be equal to how much? 180 degrees. So we can write, from figure, angle AOC plus AOC, then COE, angle COE plus, then BOE, angle BOE, which is equal to what? 180 degree. Okay. Now we can arrange the term AOC and BOE, take together angle AOC plus angle BOE, then plus the next one, angle COE, that will be equal to 180. And what is AOC plus BOE? It is given as 70 degree. So 70 degree plus angle COE equal to 180 degrees. And therefore angle COE equal to 180 minus 70. And what is 180 minus 70? 110. So angle COE equal to 110 degree. Okay. COE 110. Now we can consider the line COD, this line, and if we add these three angles, it will be equal to how much? 180 degree. Okay. Now we can write angle COE plus BOE, then plus angle BOD, that will be equal to 180 degree, since COD is a line. Okay. And COE, we know the value 110 degree. Then plus BOE. BOE we have to find out. Angle BOE. Okay. So write as it is. Angle BOE. Then plus angle BOD. That is angle BOD 40 degree. So 40 which is equal to 180. 110 plus 40. 110 plus 40 is what? 150. Then plus angle BOE. That will be equal to 180 degree. And angle BOE is equal to 180 degree minus 150 degree, which is equal to 30 degree. So measure of angle BOE will be equal to how much? 30 degrees. Okay. Now next one is, we have to find the reflex angle COE. Okay, reflex angle COE. In order to find the reflex of an angle, we have to subtract the particular angle measured from 360 degree. Okay. To find the reflex of an angle, we have to subtract the angle measured from 360 degree. Here we got angle COE as 110 degree. So the reflex of reflex angle COE equal to 360 minus angle COE. It is equal to 360 minus 110, and that will be equal to 250 degree. Okay. Therefore, reflex angle COE will be equal to 250 degree. Clear? Now we move on to the second question. In figure, lines XY and MN intersect at O. If angle POY equal to 90 degree, POY, this is 90 degree, and A is to B equal to 2 is to 3. Here it is A and here it is B. A is to B equal to, the ratio is given 2 is to 3. We have to find angle C, this angle. Okay. So given angle POY equal to 90 degree and A is to B is equal to 2 is to 3. So from this ratio, we can write A is equal to 2K and B is equal to 3K. Okay. Now, what is A plus B? Here total 180 degree and POY is 90 degree. So the remaining is also equal to 90 degree. So we can write A plus B is equal to 90 degree from the figure. Okay. Then we can replace the value of A and B. 2K plus 3K equal to 90 degree. 5K is equal to 90 degree. K is equal to 90 by 5, which is equal to 18 degrees. Okay. Now we can find the value of A and B first. A is equal to 2K. That is 2 into 18, which is equal to 36 degree. B is equal to 3K. That is 3 into 18, which is equal to 54 degrees. And we have to find, finally we have to find C. Okay, we can consider B and C. MON is a straight line, or MN is a straight line. So B plus C will be equal to how much? 180 degrees. Okay, this is a straight line, so straight angle measure is 180 degree, or we can say linear pair of angles. Okay, now B plus C is equal to 180 degree. B plus C is equal to 180 degree linear pair. B value is how much? 54. So 54 plus C is equal to 180, and C is equal to 180 minus 54. 180 minus 54 is what? 126 degrees. So the value of C is 126 degrees. Okay. Here the next question is, in figure, angle PQR equal to angle PRQ. PQR equal to PRQ. Okay, these two angles are equal. Prove that PQS equal to PRT. PQS, this angle, it is equal to PRT. This one. Okay. First of all, we can write, given angle PQR is equal to angle PRQ. Okay. Now we can take these two angles, PQS and PQR. What about these two angles? These are linear pair of angles. Okay. So angle PQS plus angle PQR will be equal to 180 degree. You can take it as equation number 1. Here is another pair of linear pair, PRQ, PRQ and PRT, these two angles. Okay, that also we can write angle PRQ, then plus angle PRT will be equal to 180 degree. We can take it as equation number 2. For both, we can write the same reason, linear pair. Okay, linear pair. So in these two equations, the RHS part is equal, so we can equate the LHS part. From 1 and 2, we get angle PQS plus angle PQR equal to angle PRQ plus angle PRT. But it is given that angle PQR equal to angle PRQ. Angle PQR is equal to angle PRQ, so both values we can cancel, both are equal. Okay, therefore we get angle PQS equal to angle PRT, that we have to prove. Angle PQS equal to angle PRT, clear? Now we move on to question number 4. In figure, if x plus y equal to w plus z, then prove that AOB is a line. Okay, here one condition is given, x plus y equal to w plus z. We have to prove AOB is a straight line. Okay, we know the sum of angles around a point is how much? 360 degrees. So we can write x plus y plus z plus w is equal to 360 degree. So from the figure, it is clear that x plus y plus w plus z is equal to 360 degree. Okay, the angle around a point is equal to 360 degree. Now we can replace the value of w plus z by x plus y. So x plus y plus, again we can write x plus y instead of w plus z, because both are equal, it is given 360. X plus y, that is 2 into x plus y, 2 times, which is equal to 360 degree, and x plus y is equal to 360 divided by 2, which is equal to 180 degree. Now observe the figure, x and y are adjacent angles. Okay, x and y are adjacent angles, and the sum of these two adjacent angles will be equal to 180 degrees. That means by linear pair axiom, the non-common arms of the angle forms a line. Here the non-common arms are OA and OB. Since the sum of angles is 180 degree, we can say AOB is a line. Therefore, we can write AOB is a line. Understood? Now the next question is, in figure POQ is a line, POQ is a straight line, ray OR, OR is perpendicular to the line PQ, OR is perpendicular to PQ, OS is another ray, OS is another ray lying between the rays OP and OR. Prove that angle ROS, this one, angle ROS equal to half into angle QOS minus angle POS. So first of all, we can take angle QOS, and angle QOS can be written as QOS, QOR plus ROS. Sum of these two angles. Okay. So which is equal to angle QOR plus angle ROS. Okay. And angle QOR. QOR is how much? Since it is a perpendicular, this much angle is 90 degree. So 90 plus angle ROS. We can take it as equation number 1. That is angle QOS equal to 90 plus angle ROS. Now take the second term, angle POS. Angle POS equal to, here it is POS. This can be written as POR, this 90 degree angle, POR minus ROS. Okay, POR minus ROS. So angle POR minus angle ROS. And here also POR is 90 degree. So 90 minus angle ROS. Take it as equation 2. Angle POS equal to 90 degree minus angle ROS. Now we can take the difference between these two. For that we can subtract 1 and 2. Equation 1 minus 2 implies angle QOS minus angle POS, which is equal to 90 plus angle ROS minus of 90 minus angle ROS. You can remove the bracket. 90 plus angle ROS minus 90 minus of minus plus plus angle ROS. This minus 90 plus 90 we can cancel. ROS plus ROS, that is 2 into angle ROS. 2 into angle ROS. Left side is angle QOS minus angle POS, which is equal to 2 angle ROS. That 2 we can divide. So 1 by 2 into this term will be equal to angle ROS. Or ROS can be written as angle ROS equal to 1 by 2 into angle QOS minus angle POS. Hence the proof. Okay, angle ROS equal to 1 by 2 into angle QOS minus angle POS. Clear? Now we move on to the last question in this exercise. It is given that angle XYZ is equal to 64 degree and XY is produced to a point P. Draw a figure from the given information. Okay, first of all we have to draw a figure. XY is equal to 64 degree. So we can draw an acute angle. X, here we can mark Y and here is Z, is 64 degree. XY is produced to a point P. So we can extend this line XY to a point P. Okay. XY is produced to a point P. If ray OQ bisect angle ZOP. So we have to draw an angle bisector YQ. Okay, YQ. Here OQ bisect angle ZOP. That means these two angles are equal. Okay. Bisect means divide into two equal parts. Okay. This is the figure. So here we can write, since YQ bisect angle ZOP, comma, we have angle QYP or angle PYQ, both are same. So QYP. Angle QYP will be equal to angle ZYQ or QYZ. Okay, these two angles are equal. Let it be X. We can take this angle as X. Both are equal. Say it is X. Okay, let us suppose the measure is X. Now we can add these three angles. Since XYP is a straight line, the sum of these three angles will be equal to how much? 180 degrees. Okay. So from the figure, we can write angle XYZ plus angle QYZ plus angle QYP which is equal to 180 degree. Okay. Angle XYZ is 64 degree. QYZ, we take it as X. QYP is also X, which gives 180 degree. X plus X is 2X. 2X equal to 180 minus 64. That is 2X is equal to 180 minus 64 is 116. And X is equal to 116 divided by 2. That is 58. The value of X is 58. That means here the measure is equal to 58 degree. Here also 58 degrees. Okay. Now we got the answer. We have to find angle XYQ. XYQ. For that we can add these two measures. So angle XYQ equal to 64 plus 58. And 64 plus 58 is what? Here 8 plus 4 is 12. 2, 1 balance. Here 2. 122 degrees. XYQ is equal to XYQ. 64 plus 58. 122 degrees. Now the reflex of angle QYP. What is angle QYP? QYP is 58 degree. So angle QYP is equal to 58 degree. Therefore, reflex angle QYP equal to find the reflex, we have to subtract the measure from 360. So, 360 minus 58, which gives 302 degrees, 302 degrees. Okay. So, this finishes exercise 6.1. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Thank you.